Good evening and welcome to the special broadcast from the Tribune Network. A big breaking story we're discussing right now, the resignation of RBI Governor Urjit Patel. Just a while back, a statement issued from the RBI Governor's office informing that the RBI Governor had resigned, citing personal reasons. Remember, in the last couple of months, there have been reports about the autonomy row between the RBI Governor's office and the Union Government, and now the resignation of Urjit Patel. Joining me now, my senior colleague, Mr. Rajiv Jaiswal, on the issue. Rajiv, what would be the probable reason there have been an autonomy row between Urjit Patel and the Union Government? Now, suddenly this decision of resigning comes in. What could be the probable reasons?
Today is the news day, Rohit, and it was expected that RBI Governor may resign. He has cited personal reason, and we must respect his reason, but we can go beyond it. One was the tiff between Finance Ministry and RBI. But that is quite known to everyone that RBI Governor and Finance Ministry, they were not on the same page. That was over reserves. Finance Ministry wanted about 3 lakh crore reserves to be released for them, which is not possible as per the law, and it needs amendment. So the tiff was quite obvious, known, and it was in media. That is obvious issue. I want to go slightly beyond. What I see is an opportunism. Mr. Urjit Patel worked for 2 years, slightly more than 2 years, and at the terminal year of this government, when this government appears to be shaky, he is resigning. So this is general trend among the intellectuals and technocrats, because they don't want to get rid of the previous government. Incoming government. So it's a very good time that you have spent good time in a government and then you are getting out of it. Had Mr. Urjit Patel would have resigned after demonetization, I would have said he has taken a moral stand. Because beyond this particular issue of RBI reserves, the major issue was demonetization, which was completely ill-conceived, and Mr. Patel wrote about it in his book that it was a bad move. Despite all these things, he did not resign at the time of demonetization. So ideally he should have resigned then. That would have been a major moral feat for him.
But the question will be raised, you know, from one institution to another, you have judiciary, you have problems within the RBI, and the RBI governor is resigning before that, you have problems in the Supreme Court. There are various issues, institutional issues which have cropped up during this particular government. Does this resignation of Mr. Urjit Patel send across a very wrong signal, that you're bungling from one crisis to another for the Union government?
Certainly, this is a crisis for the Union government as far as management of finance and monetary system is concerned, and it is a matter of concern. Could be possible, we will come to know later in a day or two, that whether there was any other major issues or not. But morally, if you see and if you read the letter Mr. Patel has written, his resignation letter, there he is not, as far as it is in media, I don't know whether it's a correct letter, whether it's his resignation letter or not, but he has not thanked anyone. So that shows the mind of the person who is leaving the office, which is not in good taste. But this tiff was not an outcome of a day or a month. It was building up since demonetization, and ideally Mr. Urjit Patel should have resigned then and there. Then he would have been a moral high ground.
Thank you so much, Rajiv. So there you have an insight by Jaiswal, as he mentioned, the tiff has been on for quite some time now culminating in Mr. Urjit Patel finally stepping down, though he has cited personal reasons. But given the run-on between the government and the RBI since the last few months, many speculating that it was on account of the differences that have emerged between the RBI as an institution and the Union Finance Ministry. We'll keep on updating the story, following up on this story. You can also track the story on our website, tribuneindia.com, or also follow us on our Twitter page at Twitter at Tribune CHD, and also our Facebook page. Thanks for watching.